Hello everyone. Today we are going to do class 8 maths chapter number 17 circle, chord and arc, practice set number 17.1 we are going to complete today. In a circle with center P and chord AB is drawn of length 13 cm. Okay, find PQ that is perpendicular to the chord AB, then find length of OB. Okay. QB, it should be QB children, okay. We have to find this length, okay. Now, whatever has been given, that is length of AB, which is 13 cm. This is 13 cm. Then PQ, that is segment PQ perpendicular to chord AB, okay. So, therefore, length of QB is equal to half of length AB. Okay, now see children, it's a simple logic. If this is 13 centimeter, okay, and when a perpendicular is drawn, the straight line is drawn on any chord or on any line, it is said that it is divided into two equal parts. Means this is going to be divided into two equal parts. Okay, that is why we have taken half. QB is half of AB. That's the only simple logic. Okay. So, half into 13 divided. Children, the answer is going to be 6.5 centimeter length of QB. Wasn't it easy? It's very easy. Only thing you all have to remember is when a perpendicular is drawn, it divides the line or a segment into two similar or two equal parts. Okay, let's solve the next question. Radius of a circle with center O is 25 centimeter. Find the distance of a chord from the center if the length of the chord is 48 centimeter. Okay, so everything has been given. We have to write what is there. So, this is the diagram that I have drawn. Okay. Now, over here, radius of the circle with the center O is 25 centimeter. Okay. So, this is supposed to be our radius, that is OD. And if the length of the chord is 48. So, this is 48 centimeter. Okay. So, we will write what has been given. That is length of OD is 25 centimeter. Length of CD is 48 centimeter. Okay, this is the chord, this is the radius. Okay, and segment OP is perpendicular to the chord CD. It's very important to write this statement, children, because from this statement only the next step we have to take. Okay, so length of PD is equal to half the length of CD, isn't it? P and D is going to be half. As I said in the last question also, the chord is divided into two equal parts after a perpendicular is drawn on it. Okay, so it is going to be half into how much is CD? 48. So 2 ones are 2s are 4s are. Therefore, length of PD is going to be how much? 24 centimeter. Okay, so this we have got now as 24 centimeter. Now you will see that we have formed a right angle, okay, in which hypotenuse and one side is there, we have to find the other side. So therefore, what we have to use by PT theorem or Pythagoras theorem, triangle OPD is a right angled triangle. Okay, so therefore, by using Pythagoras theorem, length of OD square is equal to length of OP square plus length of PD square. Okay, so OD is how much? 25. OP we have to find, so let's keep it as it is, plus 24 square. Alright, so let's take OP to left hand side, and 25 square is 2625 minus 576. So length of OP square is equal to, subtract this, the answer is 49. Therefore, length of OP is root of 49. That means length of OP is 7 centimeter. Now the conclusion, therefore, the distance of the chord from the center is 7 centimeter. That's it. Wasn't it easy? You all have to understand the concept, children. It's very easy, and these kind of sums are going to be in 9th standard as well. So now the next sum is, 0 is the center of the circle. Find the radius of the chord of the length 24 centimeter. Okay, so this is the chord which is of 24 centimeter. Reduce it with half or divide it with 2. You will be getting half of these two. Okay, now this is 9 centimeter. The distance is 9 centimeter. So whatever is been given, we will write it down. AB is 24 centimeter. Okay. OP is perpendicular chord. OP is perpendicular to chord AB, and length of OP is 9 centimeter. Whatever I said, I have written it down. Okay. So therefore, length of AP is equal to half of length of AB. Just now I explained. So half into 24 divided 2 ones are 12. Therefore, length of AP is equal to 12 centimeter. This is 1. Is it clear? Now we have got AP. Okay. P is over here, children. I have not mentioned it. AP is 12 centimeter. Now you will see that we have got a right angle triangle again. How? See, this is 9 centimeter. AP is how much? 12 centimeter. And again, we have to find a hypotenuse. So two sides we are having, and hypotenuse we have to found. We have to find. So by PT theorem, triangle OPA is a right angled triangle. Therefore, length of OA square is equal to length of OP square plus length of AP square. Okay, Pythagoras theorem I have added, children. So this is going to be 9 square, 12 square, length of OA square. So this is going to be 81 plus 144 length of OA square. So now what we have to do, we have to add it, that is OA square is equal to 225. So therefore, length of OA is equal to root 225, isn't it? Therefore, OA is equal to 15 centimeter. Now we have to conclude the radius of the circle is 15 centimeter. Is it clear, children? It's very easy. Let's solve the fourth question now. C is the center of the circle whose radius is 10. Find the distance of the chord. We have to find the distance of the chord from the center if the length of the chord is 12 centimeter. Okay, so this is 12 centimeter. Obviously, first we have to find AM so that we will get hypotenuse, and one side it will be very easy with to find the other side with Pythagoras theorem. So CM, perpendicular chord, perpendicular to chord AB. Okay, CM is a perpendicular chord to AB. Then what has been given? Length of AC is equal to 10 centimeter, and length of AB is equal to 12 centimeter. Okay, so therefore, length of AM is going to be half of length of AB. The same as we took to find the half of AB we have to take AM. So half of AB is how much? 12. So 2 ones are 2 6 are. So this is going to be 6 centimeter. AM is going to be 6 centimeter. Okay, now that we have got one side, our triangle is formed, isn't it? Which triangle? Triangle CMA. CMA is a right angled triangle. So what formula we have to use over here? By PT theorem or by Pythagoras, length of CA square is equal to length of CM square plus length of AM square. So CM is how much? 10 square. CA is 10 square. CM we have to find, plus AM is how much? Just now we found it. Okay, so its square is going to be 100. Excuse me. CM square plus 36. Let's take CM to the left hand side and all the numbers to the right hand side. Subtract it. You will be getting CM is equal to 64. CM square. Therefore, length of CM is going to be root of 64. That means length of CM is supposed to be 8 centimeter. Okay. So, 8 is the root of 64. Now we have got our answer. So concluded, distance of the chord from the center is 8 centimeter. Got it, children? Now we are having 2 minutes, so I will again explain you what concept we are using over here. So children, if this is a circle, okay, and this is a chord, this is a perpendicular drawn, these are going to be our radius. Okay, so this is going to be our radius. Perpendicular drawn is always 90 degree, and when a perpendicular is drawn, that means when this line is drawn, it divides the chord into two equal parts. Okay, that means if this is 6 centimeter, so when a perpendicular is drawn, it will divide the line into 3 centimeter and 3 centimeter. That's it. We have to only find first the half of the chord, and when any of this side is already been given to us, we have to use the Pythagoras theorem and then find the remaining side of the triangle, because you will see that we have formed a triangle which is 90 degree, and by the use of Pythagoras theorem, we can find the remaining side of the triangle. Okay, so it is very simple. Don't get confused. Still, if there is any confusion, please let me know in the comment section. I'll try to answer your queries. The next exercise, that is 17.2, will be posted tomorrow. So see you tomorrow. Till then, take care. Bye.